Hey y'all, this is another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas, and we're just a bunch of WordPress nerds that geek out, nerd out on all this fun stuff. Today specifically, I want to talk to you about best practices when it comes to your WordPress plugins. How many should you be running? Do you need to update them when there's an update alert? How do you choose the best plugins? Let's get into it. I'm going to make this video as short as possible though, so you can just learn quickly. If you need to, pause me and rewind me. Here we go. Looking at your plugins, of course, this is only relevant to those that are running on a self-hosted version of WordPress. So if you're running on WordPress.com, you are not going to be able to see this area inside of your dashboard. You need to have a self-hosted version. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll put another video link down in the description box below. Click the Show More option and you'll be able to see a link to a video that will explain the difference between .com and .org version of WordPress. All right, for all those who have a self-hosted version and you're thinking, okay, gosh, I log in here and I've got 32 active plugins. Thankfully, this install, we only have 5 active plugins. How many plugins should you be running? So there's nothing over on the codex that designates a specific number. This is only my opinion after years and years and years of developing WordPress websites. What we've seen is right about the limit of a dozen plugins. You start to see the website really slow down, become very sluggish in loading pages. We also start to see some conflicts of code, which is a serious concern. Some breaking things take place or just some wonkiness happening on the site. So please be sure as you're coming into your dashboard here, taking a look at your plugins, that, you know, if you have more than a dozen active, the fewer the better, right, y'all? The fewer the better. But if you have over that, I want you to take a look and see, can I eliminate some of these? Or are they all necessary? You certainly don't need 2 caching plugins. One's good enough if you have to have it, if your host doesn't already provide that. You don't need multiple security plugins. Again, your host should be providing that for you like WP Engine does. If they're not doing that, then one plugin's plenty. You do not need multiple SEO plugins. Just try to go through here and see what's absolutely necessary. And you're gonna find the more of these that you can eliminate, the faster your website's gonna load, the less hassle in maintaining all these and making sure they're all up to date, which is a huge, huge necessity. You always need to be sure that these plugins are fully up to date. And you can see right here that there's an alert telling me that my Visual Composer plugin is requiring an update. There's a new version available. So it's a little tricky if you've got a premium plugin like this to make this update happen. But for the most part, it's super simple just to click one button and click an update option in here and things are up to date and secure yet again, right? Super important that you do that. And what about choosing a plugin? What's the best practice when it comes to choosing a plugin? Going here and clicking add new plugin to your website, of course, if we're under 12, right? We don't want to be adding more than 12. And that's just our opinion. That's just a WebTegrity standard. We like to see websites go live with actually 7 or less. But sometimes you have to have those photo galleries or the Yoast plugin, like what I'm showing you here. And this is a best practice. When you're going to go search for any plugin out there, you want to look at a couple of things to be sure that it's adequate or safe enough to use on your website. So first things first, go have a backup of your website in place before you start adding anybody else's code or plugin. You just definitely want to be sure that you have that in place. If you don't know how to do that, I have another video that teaches you how to back up your WordPress website for free. I'll put that in the description box below as well. Once that backup is in place and you know today that you have a current version in case something goes weird here that you can roll us back, you can come here. We're looking specifically at the Yoast SEO plugin, which is a great plugin for helping you be responsible for your content, held accountable to how you're writing your content on your website for best practices when it comes to SEO. What I want you to check are a few things using any plugin for that matter. You want to be sure it has a lot of installs so we know this is tried and true. You also want to be sure that it's compatible with your most recent version of WordPress. That simply means that there should be no errors once you click activate, so that's great to know. And the other thing is you want to be sure that it's been updated recently. What you don't want to do is come in here and try to find a plugin to use and it has been updated, you know, 2 years ago. That more than likely is going to be a red flag to anybody trying to hack your website. So even this one with a year ago, I would just say, you know, this one says untested. It's only got 2,000, even though it's got pretty good reviews. Still try to go with something that's definitely more tried and true. So that's best practices when it comes to choosing a plugin. And of course, that goes the same for you bouncing over to an area for premium plugins. You want to always be sure that as you're searching through for different premium plugins, that same thing, great reviews, that it's been around for a long time, that it's ready to go for your most recent version, and that all the authors are responding great for support with any questions that you may have. All this is so important, y'all. You need to be sure that all your plugins are up to date. And if you're struggling with this, or if some of this seems a little over your head, please give us a call over here at WebTegrity. Shoot us an email over on WebTegrity.com. Give us a tweet. Somehow reach out to us. We'd love to help you be sure that your website is safe, optimized, and loading quickly so Google loves you, and so that your users have a really great experience being on your website. We hope you have a great WordPress Wednesday. Subscribe, because I'll be doing this every week. See you next time. Bye-bye, y'all.